In the similar way, how we have done the standard Rotter compression test to determine the maximum radiance and optimum moisture content of the Guyon soil sample. In the similar way, we are going to find out the for modified Rotter compression test to determine the maximum radiance and optimum moisture content of the Guyon soil sample. Here we can observe that what is the difference between standard compression and modified compression. Mainly for loose soils, wherever the soil will be soft, we are going for modified Rotter compression test. Wherever the soil will be little bit hard, means if there is any friction, little bit of friction is present, we are going to do standard Rotter compression test. Similarly, for what are the rural roads, what are the village roads, we are going for standard Rotter compression test. And for the construction of highways, we are going for modified Rotter compression test. Depending upon the foundation, we are going for modified or standard compression test. Here also apparatus will be the same, that is cylindrical mold and rammer. Here the rammer will be changing. Here the rammer will be of larger rammer, means big rammer we are going to use. Here we are going to use larger rammer, which will be of 4.9 kg rammer, and height of fall will be of 45 cm. Here this is the rammer which we are going to use for doing modified Rotter compression test. Here the height of fall will be 45 cm. What is the height of fall we can observe? 45 cm. Again, granulated jar for measuring the water and mold accessories, whatever the collar, base plate and the mold, and inner standard ISC, whatever the soil that is passed through retained on 20 mm micron seal that we are going to use. Just balance of weighing the weight of the soil, whether it is a dry soil or wet soil, and straight edge and spatula is used for making the soil in a straight condition without making any undulations. This large mixing pan. This is the mixing pan which we are going to use to conduct modified Rotter compression test.
Here, in the similar way how we have done standard Rotter compression test, here we are going to do the modified Rotter compression test. Here, what is the difference between standard and modified means, for standard, we are going to take 3 layers of soil sample, 2.5 kg of soil sample, and for 2.5 kg of soil sample, we are going to divide the soil into 3 layers. Whereas, coming to modified Rotter compression test, we are going to take the 5 kg of soil sample. In the modified Rotter compression test, we are going to take 5 kg of soil sample, and we are going to divide the soil into 5 layers. Depending upon the mold, depending upon the foundation, sometimes we may go for 5 kg or in the 2.5 kg also, we are going to divide into 5 layers. And for each layer, we are going to give 25 blows. For 5 layers, for each layer, we are going to give 25 blows. And whatever the compression we are going to use, that should be throughout the mold. Means we should not fix only a particular area. Throughout the mold, we have to do compression. And in the standard Rotter compression test, we are going to use 2.6 kg hammer. Here, whereas in the modified Rotter compression test, we are going to use 4.9 kg rammer. And there we can observe that in the standard Rotter compression test, height of fall is 31 cm. Whereas in the modified Rotter compression test, we can observe the height of fall is increased to 45 cm. Means, as we are going for bigger foundations, to bear the larger loads, we are going to use the modified Rotter compression test. Here, ultimate aim is that to find out the optimum moisture content and maximum dry density of the given soil sample. Whatever the soil sample we are taking, we are going to find out the optimum moisture content and maximum dry density of the given soil sample. Here, we are doing every test for 5 trials, means 4 to 5 trials. After doing the 4 to 5 trials, we can get the perfect results. Based upon that results only, we are going to estimate what is the optimum moisture content, that is the maximum moisture content and maximum dry density of the given soil sample. Here, after this, we are going to collect the soil sample in the bin by taking the empty weight of the bin. In this way, we are going to remove the soil sample from the collar, means how we are going to separate the collar from the mold, by removing the collar and by removing the waste part of the soil sample. In this way, we can see the after removing the collar, whatever the soil part, and we have to take the weight of the mold with soil sample. And after we have taken the weight, we have to extract the soil sample with the help of sample extractor. In this way, after taking the wet weight of the soil sample with the mold, we are going to extract the soil sample from the mold. After extracting the soil sample, we are going to take the some amount of soil from three layers, and we are going to take the weight of wet soil, and after 24 hours from the oven, we are going to get the weight of dry soil. Initially, we have to take the empty weight of the bin. Before placing the soil sample, we have to take the empty weight of the bin, that is the W1. After taking the empty weight of the bin, we have taken the weight of the wet soil, means by taking some little bit of soil from the three layers. From each layer, we have to take the soil sample from the first, second, and third layers. After removing the color, that is the top part, we are removing, and we are going to take the wet weight of the soil sample. And after this, to get the dry weight, we are going to keep it in oven for 24 hours. కొంచెం ఆయిల్ తీసేసి ఇక్కడ 24 hours వి కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ దట్ దర్ ఇస్ ఎ చేంజ్ ఇన్ ద వెయిట్ దట్ ఈస్ ఇనిషియల్లీ ఇట్ విల్ బి ఆఫ్ 52 నౌ ఇట్ హాస్ బీన్ కమ్ టు 46 grams యాజ్ ద మాయిశ్చర్ కంటెంట్ ఈస్ రిమూవ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద సాయిల్ ఇట్స్ వెయిట్ ఈస్ రెడ్యూస్డ్ అగైన్ విత్ హెల్ప్ ఆఫ్ యూజింగ్ యూనిట్ వెయిట్ ఆఫ్ ద డ్రై డెన్సిటీ వీఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు ఫైండ్ అవుట్ వాట్ ఈస్ ద మాయిశ్చర్ కంటెంట్ ప్రజెంట్ ఇన్ ద పర్టికులర్ సాయిల్ ఇన్ ద స్టాండర్డ్ ప్రొటర్ కాంపాక్షన్ టెస్ట్ While doing the test, these are the observations which were made. That is, what is the diameter of the mold as 10 cm, and the height of the mold which was recorded was 12.7 cm, and the empty weight of mold was 1.942 kg, and the empty weight of tray was 0.624 kg. These are the observations which were made while conducting the test. That is, while conducting standard Proctor compaction test. Now we are going to do the calculations. First standard Proctor compaction test to find out the maximum dry density and optimum moisture content of given soil sample. Next, for this we have to take first as determination number. And as we have done for 5 number of samples to get the curve for maximum dry density and optimum moisture content. 1, 2, 3, 4. And first one is a mass of mold plus compacted soil. This we have to represent in graphs. Second one is the mass of compacted soil, which will be in grams, and third one is the wet density that will be represented by gamma wet equal to weight by volume, which will be in grams per cc. First, whatever we have recorded during the test, that is mass of mold plus compacted soil for first sample, second sample, third, fourth and fifth. For first sample we got mass of mold plus compacted soil as 3712, and for second sample we got 3906, and for third sample we got it as 4046, and for fourth sample, that is, we got 4003. Next, for fifth sample we got 4020. This is the mass of mold plus compacted soil. Here in the second column we have represented mass of compacted soil. Here mass of compacted soil means mass of mold plus compacted soil, that is 3712 minus mass of mold, and that is weight of mold 1.942 kg means 1942 grams. That is 3712 mass of mold plus compacted soil minus 1942 empty weight of mold. We will get it as 1770. In the similar way, 3906 minus 1942, that is, what is the empty weight of mold? We'll get it as 1964. The similar way for third, fourth, and fifth, 2464, 2161, and 2078. We got mass of mold plus compacted soil plus mass of compacted soil. Now we are going to get the weight density, that is gamma weight is equal to weight by volume. What is the volume of the mold? That is 1770 weight of compacted soil by volume, that is 1000. We will get it as 1.774. Next, in the similar way, we are going to get this as 1.969, 2.4703. Here, how we got volume of the mold means, for calculations, volume of mold, we will be equal to, as it is a, whatever the mold we are going to use, it is circular mold. That's why we are going to calculate volume of the mold, V is equal to pi r square h. We know pi means, either we can use 22/7 or 3.14 for pi. That is 3.14 into r square, that is our radius. Radius means diameter by 2, that is 10 by 2, we got 5. 5 is the whole square into height of the mold, that is 12.7 centimeter. We will get volume of the mold as 997.46 centimeter cube. Here we got volume of the mold. We are going to calculate the shear. Gamma weight is equal to weight by volume. That is, gamma weight be equal to weight by volume. Here, what is the weight means? We got initial as 1770, weight of compacted soil, that is 1770 divided by volume of the mold, that is 997.46. We will get it as 1.774 gram per cc. In the similar way, for second soil sample, gamma weight is equal to weight by volume. We got W as 1964 divided by volume of the mold, we got it as 997.46. We will get it as 1.969 grams per cc. In the similar way, for third, fourth and fifth samples, we are going to calculate whatever the weight density of the soil sample. We get it as 2.1665, next 2.083. Next, fourth one, we have taken the bin numbers. What are the bin numbers for different soil samples? For first, second, third, fourth and fifth. We have taken bin numbers as 207, 24. Whatever we have recorded during our test. Next, fifth column is mass of bin plus wet soil. Fifth column is mass of bin plus wet soil. Means whatever the soil we have collected after doing the compaction test plus mass of bin plus wet soil. For first we got it as 54 grams. For second one 52 grams, 65. Next, sixth column is mass of bin plus dry soil. After 24 hours, after keeping in the oven for 24 hours, whatever the dry soil we got in the bin, what is the bin weight? That is 53. We can observe that it is reduced from 54 to 53 due to removal of moisture content from the soil. It has been reduced to 52 to 51. Similarly, from 65 to 61, 67 to 63, and finally it is reduced from 105 to 93 and 96. We can observe that as we are increasing the moisture content, whatever the change, difference we can observe whenever we are increasing the moisture content in the particular soil. As we are increasing the moisture content, that is water percentage, automatically difference will be more from the wet soil, difference will be more between wet soil and dry soil. Next, seventh column will be of mass of water. How much water we have added, that we are going to, based upon the percentage we have added. As we have taken the clay soil, we have started from 14%. In the similar way, we are adding that as 78 ml, 156, 234, 312 and 390. In this way, so mass of moisture content, that is 54 minus 53, 1 divided by whatever the 1 divided by 30 mass of dry soil, we'll get it as 3.33%. And for second sample, 52 minus 51, that is 1 divided by 29, we got it as 3.4%. In the similar way, 65 minus 61, 4 divided by 44, we'll get it as 9.09%. And 67 minus 63, 4 divided by 43, we got it as 9.30%. And 105 minus 96, that is 9 divided by 65, we'll get it as 13.84%. We got the moisture content. Now we have to find out the dry density. What is the dry density of the particular soil sample? After oven drying, what is the dry density present in the particular soil sample? Dry density can be found out by gamma dry is equal to gamma wet by 1 plus moisture content, which you have studied in soil maker, geotechnical engineering, in the first chapter, that is gamma dry is equal to gamma wet by 1 plus moisture content. Gamma wet, we got it as 1.774, we got it as gamma wet 1.774 divided by 1 plus moisture content, that is 33. We will get it as 1.717. In the similar way, 1.969 divided by 1 plus moisture content, 3.4. We will get it as 1.909. And for third sample, we got it as 2.266. And for fourth, 1.982. And for fifth, we got 1.829. After obtaining the moisture content and dry density, we are going to draw the graph between moisture content and dry density of the particular soil sample. Here, in this way, we are going to draw the graph. Moisture content is on x-axis and dry density will be drawn on the y-axis. After representing the moisture content on x-axis and dry density on y-axis, here we can see whatever the moisture content and dry density we got from the calculations. Whatever the moisture content means, for 1.717, for moisture content 3.3%, dry density is 1.7. Here for 3.3% and whatever the dry density is of 1.7, here we have plotted a point. In the similar way, for 3.4, 1.09, here second point, that is 1.09, and for third point, for 9.09, 2.266, here for 9.09, 2.26, and similarly for fourth point, that is 9.30, 1.982, that is 9.30, 1.982. This is the fourth soil sample. Next, finally, fifth one is the, for 13.84, we got 1.829. That is 13 means here 13.89, we'll get it as 1.829. Here, after obtaining the points, you have to draw the smooth curve. That's in the curve, at the center, it should be in a, the center, it should be in a curved portion. Means, we should not draw with the scale. We should draw with our hand, free hand. If you draw the graph, whatever the point, that is the center point is there. In the graph, whatever the middle portion is there, that is the maximum dry density. After getting the particular point, that is the highest point, we are going to draw the straight line on x-axis as well as on y-axis. On x-axis, we got it as moisture content as 9.1%. At the third sample, at the maximum choice, you will get the optimum moisture content and dry density at third soil sample only. Why? Because after increasing the water level, after third point, water density will be reduced. Means, this is the moisture content. Whatever the moisture content, we got it as 9.1%. And for similarly, if we draw the straight line to the y-axis, we will get dry density as 2.266. This is the moisture content and dry density. This is suitable for the particular soil. Whatever the soil we have used, this is the moisture content and dry density which you are going to use. Here, after obtaining the calculations, you will get the result as, that is first one, optimum moisture content, of given soil sample, that is OMC, we'll call it as OMC in the short form, OMC from graph. And second one, we'll find out maximum ride density of UN soil sample, that is gamma dry. We will represent gamma dry, dry density in gamma dry. Gamma means unit weight of soil. As we are finding out maximum dry density, gamma dry max from graph. Here in the graph, I will show how we got the optimum moisture content and dry density. Here, this is the optimum moisture content. Optimum moisture content means here we can represent. Here, this is the point. What is the top portion? And from the top portion in the curve, we are going to draw a straight line. We got it as optimum moisture content as 9.1%. In the graph, we can observe that is 9.1 optimum moisture content. We are going to represent 9.1% as optimum moisture content. Next, maximum dry density. Here, from this point, we are going to draw a straight line. We are going to get it as below 2.3 it is there. That means, when you calculate 2.1, 2.2, 2.3, 2.4, 2.5, we will get it as 2.2, 2.25, 2.27 graph. We got optimum moisture content as 9.1% and maximum dry density as 2.27%. Whatever the moisture which we are removed by doing oven drying, that we cannot identify how much moisture is removed from the soil. That we are going to calculate with the help of using some formula. Moisture content. Here we can go for moisture content formula. That is moisture content M is equal to weight of water divided by weight of solids. Weight of water. Here weight of water means whatever the mass of being placed wet soil minus dry soil. 54 minus 53 we got it as 1. 1 divided by here 30 mass of dry soil. Whatever the dry soil we have found out. 1 by 30 we will get it as 3.33%. In the similar way, for second soil sample we will get it as 52 minus 51. 52 minus 51 which will be of for second moisture content. For second soil sample to find the moisture content, 52 minus 51 1 divided by mass of solids, that is 29. We will get it as 0.29%. In the similar way, 65 minus 61, for third one, 65 minus 61, we got it as 4. 4 divided by 44. For fourth, we will take it as 67 minus 63. That is 4. 4 divided by 43. And for fifth, we will get it as 105 minus 96. That is 9 divided by 65. After calculating, we will get it as first one we got 3.33%, second one 3.4, third one 9.09, fourth 9.30, and fifth we got it as 13.84%.